Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today, as I said in the last video, I'm going to give you an update on the Architects 3DP Mega. First of all, I want to apologize to all of you for all this long wait. Not only my YouTube subscribers or Patreon supporters, but also all the sponsors that are involved in this project. I have received a lot of messages via Patreon, also YouTube comments and emails asking for the Architects 3DP Mega. And after almost 2 years, I'm happy to announce that it's gonna be back in the channel with periodical updates. And hopefully it is gonna be built and ready to print very soon. For those who don't know the project, the Architects 3DP Mega is a big size and industrial quality 3D printer that I'm designing and building step by step from scratch along this series here at Architects 3DP. This project is only being possible thanks to my Patreon supporters that help me keep going month to month,
and the amazing sponsors of the Architects 3DP Mega that you can see on screen. The last video of this series was the 10th episode, published on December 14th, 2019. Back then, we did put together the x-axis of the Mega, and we also assembled the two skates that will attach the x-bridge to the y-axis of the printer from both sides.
2 years later, we have more or less the same, but here in the new studio.
Starting for the frame itself, here we have it completely assembled and ready to receive the next components, as you can see. The x-axis we assembled in the last episode is still alive. I did even install the GT2 belts that will allow the motors to move the extruders. All the cables are properly managed through the 3D printed cable chains we designed and printed, and the extruders are now holding the ends of the GT2 belts, as you can see here.
Well, so at this point, I have found two or three issues with the assembly.
And this episode is going to be the 11th of the series, where we're going to solve those issues and get the printer updated for the next episode, where we'll assemble the Y-axis.
But before starting, I want to announce you our sponsor for this video, PCB Way.
Today, I'm going to focus on their 3D printing service that you can find right here. With PCBWay, it's extremely easy to get your 3D printed parts at home within a few days. For that, you just have to drag and drop your files as you are watching on screen. Select all the parameters for the print, such as material, finish, etc., and you will get an instant quotation and estimation of the time, that as you can see for this piece, is only 4 to 6 days. They even have a very cool 3D viewer where you can check your object to print. In our case, it is one of the parts of the y-axis of the Mega guys. Alright, so back to the Mega. The first issue is that the cable chains, despite they fit perfectly on top of the aluminium extruded profile, due to the movements and vibrations, the cable chain ends up falling down, what Kool calls a failed print.
To solve that, I need to design a cable chain holder that we're going to install from the back of the axis.
The other issue are the GT2 pulleys, that as you can see, and maybe you can probably remember from the last episode, have a 6mm bore and the motor axis is only 5mm, which makes the belt wobble and causes a not uniform movement of the extruders. To solve that, I bought a new set of 5mm bore, 16 teeth, GT2 pulleys that we're going to use for the two motors of the x-axis, as well as the two motors of the y-axis.
Alright, so once those issues are solved, we'll be all set to continue with the build. The next steps of the design and build of this printer, once we solve those problems, will go as it follows.
I've designed and printed the components that will form the y-axis of the printer. They are printed in PLA that I bought from Sakata 3D, since I haven't tested them yet, but they will be printed with the beautiful Ambar PETG from Sakata 3D Filaments, sponsor of the build, once we test fit all the parts. These magic purple parts will go on the back of the y-axis, and the black ones on the front. Both of them have the insert for the two Hewin railings that Dam and CNC provided when this project started, and I have right here. The Hewin railing will be bolted to the structure of the printer, but will also be subjected by the two 3D printed parts we have just seen. Before assembling them, we'll have to insert the white skates we assembled in the last episode on the railings, and once everything is assembled, we'll just bolt together the skates with the x-axis ends. All the cables coming out from each of the ends of the x-axis will be properly managed through the new cable chains that I have printed, that will connect the skate to the y-axis 3D printed part on the back, and will go down to the electronics that will be on the bottom. We have to notice here that the cables coming out of the motors of the x-axis are quite short, so we'll have to weld the four wires to extension cords in order to reach the electronics on the bottom. Finally, the motors of the y-axis will be installed here in the back part, facing up, and the belt will run all the way to the front, where we'll install these GT2 idlers. Finally, the connections of the belt will happen right here in the middle, where the clamps will attach it to the Y-axis skates.
We'll do the assembly on the next video, but today I'm going to solve all the issues that I announced at the beginning of the video. First, I'm going to remove all the wrong pulleys I have installed, and I'm going to replace them with the new ones.
To do that, I'm going to release all the pressure from the belt tensioner, and once it's loose, I'm going to unscrew the two little bolts holding each pulley in place. As you can see, I did put some paper to try to solve the contact in between the two metals, but despite it improved the wobbling a lot, it wasn't enough. So that said, I'm now going to take it out and insert the 5mm bore ones, that as you can see fit just perfectly. Once installed, I'm going to tighten the bolts, put the belt back in, tighten the tensioner, and this extruder is now ready to go.
I'm going to quickly repeat the same process for the other end of the X-axis. Now we have one of the problems solved.
The next one will be the problem of the cable chains falling from the X-axis beam. As I have everything modeled in 3D, I'm going to quickly design a piece that we can easily insert from the back to hold the cable chains in place.
As always, I'm going to model it in Rhino, so I'm going to let you with the time-lapse of the process.
Okay, so here we have the components I've just designed. I'm going to test fit in place to check if it works as it should. And if it does, I will then print the other ones. So as you can see, we should slide it just like this and then turn it 90 degrees. Bad news is that I'm not able to turn it, since first we'll need to cut those fingers of the holder. I've cut them and I still can't turn them 90 degrees. And that's because the center of the piece is a prism, and its angles won't let it turn. We'll need to transform the center into a cylinder, and that's what I'm gonna do now. Alright, so now that I have printed the new part, I'm gonna test fit in place once again. Insert it like this, then turn it 90 degrees, and here we go. As you can see, it now prevents the cable chain from falling down. I'm gonna print a couple more and install them on the X-axis. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. And here we go. Now both extruders will be able to move with no problem through the X-axis and the cable chain will remain in place. Last but not least, what I'm going to do to finish this video is going to be to extend the cables of the X-axis motors so they will be able to reach the electronics on the bottom of the printer. So I'm going to weld the cables and protect them with heat shrink tubing as we always do. I will see you at the end.
As you can see, here we have the extended cables for the motors of the X-axis. Alright, so that has been everything for this video, guys. Remember that as always, you will find all the links to download the STL files down in the description, where you will also find the link for the Rhino file that I have in progress, as well as the link for the bill of materials, where you'll find all the links to buy all the necessary components we used in this episode. Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3DP if you still haven't, like the video, leave a comment, and share this episode so more people will be able to learn with us along this project. As always, I want to thank again all the sponsors of the channel, and give a special shout out to our Patreon supporters that are making this channel possible. Please consider joining them and support the channel as well at patreon.com/architects3dp. Alright guys, so as always, see you in the next video!